Making a great recruiting video is hard. You have to convince people to bet their careers on your company.
Look, I just don't believe you inspire that level of conviction by talking about your perks.
People don't join a company for the little things. You have to sell your vision.
So we're building this new web browser, this new smart browser called Dia.
A new web browser called Dia. Okay, that's a start. But what's the actual idea behind it?
The next era of computing is going to revolve around AI. That's not a big secret. But our belief specifically is that AI is not going to exist as an app. It's not going to exist as a button. AI is going to be an entirely new environment built on top of a web browser.
A new environment built on top of a web browser. Maybe one that's personal, one that's deeply integrated into your tools and workflows, maybe even an environment that can do work for you because it understands your context. Now we're getting somewhere, but the idea is still a bit vague. So you probably have to spend the rest of the video backing it up with demos of early prototypes, historical context for your thesis, and a technical deep dive on why your company is best positioned to win. Making a great recruiting video is hard, but you can't build a winning product without a winning team. So it's worth a shot.
That might do. Go.
If you join the browser company, what might you work on? Because we're building at the browser layer, we get to reimagine fundamental computing interfaces. Like this one, and this one. At this company, you get to ask, how might these generic interfaces become more personal and powerful in this next era of computing?
There's this little blinking line in every text box, email, Google Docs, just sitting there blinking. It's called the insertion cursor. What if we bring this very personalized intelligence to every text box to that cursor? So for example, Apple released the original iPhone in, I don't remember the year. Instead of having to go open a new tab, I can just click on the cursor itself and it'll go out and find, 2007. And then I can keep going. The original specs were, once again, I can just ask my cursor, hey, will you go fill that out for me? Do that research for me?
This prototype, while small and early, highlights what it means to build a new computing environment at the browser layer. This interface isn't confined to one product. We have all the context to make it personal and powerful out the box.
Because it is the browser, it understands the broader environment that it's in. I'm trying to find holiday gifts for my sisters. I open a bunch of tabs. I want my wife's advice. I can just go to my little writing buddy and say, paste the Amazon links and ask Valerie which is best for Emma. Right, so this would be usually like a back and forth between all the tabs, copy and paste the URLs, write a little thing. Instead, it'll just do that like futzing for me.
That insertion cursor demo was just the beginning. But before we show you more, let's talk about how we're able to build these things. Because the way we work is just as important as what we're building. Creating something like the insertion cursor isn't just about having good ideas. Our ability to prototype quickly at the browser layer comes from infrastructure we've been perfecting for 5 years. Starting with a foundation we call ADK.
So we started the browser company by building what we call ADK. And ADK is a totally new way to build a web browser on top of Chromium.
Instead of wrestling with Chromium C++ codebase, ADK lets our engineers prototype browser features in days instead of months.
So if you come here, you can literally dream about some wild new interface for AI and the web. We can prototype something in a couple days that would take the old way of building browsers months to do because of how gnarly it is to do it in the old way.
But we didn't stop with ADK. We spent much of this year layering 4 additional key components that will make building a new computing environment at the browser layer possible. Components like memory, which allows Dia to securely understand you and your work online. Actions, which allow for a browser to hook into your tools and do your tasks for you. LLM technology, not just as a chat interface, but mixed and matched with every other component. And finally, self-driving, the browser company's frontier bet, which will allow Dia to take large tasks off your plate completely. These components can be mixed and matched to quickly prototype features like we're demoing today. For example, our insertion cursor can use memory and LLMs. Our next demo uses both of those components as well, and it can perform actions on your behalf.
If you think about it, your browser has a lot of context about who you are and what you're working on. And so one of the things you can do in Dia is you can say, what was that doc that Cyrus sent me about Heidegger? And it's gonna go out and it's gonna search through all of the memories, which are just local on my computer, it never leaves my device. And look, it found the exact Notion doc, you know, even though I didn't remember the title. Why don't you email this to Josh and ask him what he thinks? And because it's my environment, because it's my browser, it knows what email I use because I'm logged into Gmail and I use Gmail all the time. Actually, just create a calendar event for Friday at 4 p.m. with Josh, right? And so I can think with my computer for the first time and it can wield my tools and it can do that without any special APIs. It's just the fact that it's a browser and there's a consistent theme. It's take a part of the browser that's always existed and just upgrade it to be that much more personalized and that much more intelligent. To me, this is the ultimate idea, which is let's take that little mouse cursor, that little black arrow that represents you and has for decades and say, hey, what if there was another one? And it could use your computer like you use it. Someone emails me and says, hey, we need a bunch of these things from Amazon for the shoot tomorrow. Can you go order them? It's actually a pretty easy task, but it's also very tedious. It's not creative. It's not a good use of my time. So you just say, hey, please add these items to my shopping cart on Amazon. And again, because it's the browser, it knows what you're talking about because it knows the tab you have open. It knows how to go to Amazon and it's gonna go and it's gonna click around and add each individual item from that email to your shopping cart. Right now you're looking at it, but imagine a world where actually just like send the cursor off and then you could like take a little breather, go to the bathroom, check your phone, just pause for a minute. And when you get back, all of those items will be added to your Amazon cart.
While this is a perfectly fine demo, it's the kind of task you could do on some remote third-party server. So the real question we obsess over is,
how do we automate the things that are unique to you, that are very personalized to you? And so in this situation, for example, for the shoot, we have all these crew members around here, and we had to email each of them with their call time, the location, and that was actually different per crew member. So here we can say, hey, go ahead, I want you to write emails in this format, but I want you to personalize each email to the individual, to what their name is, what their call time is, and it's gonna go in, and it's going to one by one, take the name from the doc, take the email, open up Gmail, write a custom personalized email to that person, go back. I mean, this is, think about all the coordination that you and I do every day in our jobs. This is the sort of thing, it's just teach it how to do it once and it can do it again and again and again for you.
It might seem convenient that the browser company believes the winning AI interface will be a holistic environment powered up by this new technology, but this isn't a new idea. It's a lesson history teaches us over and over and over again. Inventions alone rarely change the world. In 1879, Thomas Edison and his team in Menlo Park, New Jersey, invented a new light bulb with a carbonized bamboo filament that could last over 1,000 hours in use. Edison's light bulb was a breakthrough, as the previous standard was just a few hours.
The newspapers called it the miracle of the 19th century.
But Edison's light bulb by itself wouldn't change the world. Again, inventions alone rarely do.
The real test came when Edison announced that he would illuminate 1 square mile of the heart of New York City with a newfangled electric light.
Individual light bulbs were basically just better candles. A better candle was nice, but it didn't fulfill the promise of this revolutionary technology. It was only when we rebuilt our world around artificial light that everything changed. Night became as productive as day, and the rhythm of daily life itself was transformed. Today, we're at a similar point with AI. We've invented groundbreaking language models, but all we've managed to do is scatter AI buttons across our interfaces. Just as individual light bulbs were like better candles, these isolated AI features are just better buttons. The real transformation will come when we weave AI throughout our computing environment, and that's what we want to build toward with Dia.
So weaving it ISP on top of a browser, you could build an operating system for a device, but you have to do it front to back, the entire environment, with the idea that AI is going to be central. What we're saying is, let's break apart the web browser and let's put it back together, assuming your web browser can be very personalized to you and who you are, very aware of what you are doing, and very proactive in having your back.
If we got to the end of our recruiting video and we had shown our technical foundation, hinted at what's possible, and framed our historical moment, that would be pretty good. But a great recruiting video would probably end on a more personal note, because you can't convince someone to bet their career on your company unless you truly believe in what you're building.
Yeah, at a very personal level, I remember when we started this company, there was such this internal conviction and confidence that the browser was going to be interesting that nobody around us understood. And it was almost like that dislocation that gave me the swagger and confidence to go do it. And I feel like for a while, if I'm being really honest, when we were at the kind of peak of ARC excitement and hype, I almost had lost that internal compass and was so reactive to kind of what other people thought. And so there's this bizarre experience, honestly, after this last video we put out where no one understood, second product tossing away ARC, but just in my fucking bones, I feel like this is so obviously where the world's going.
If someone watches this video and they just take away one thing or one feeling, what do you hope it might be?
This is the unapologetically excited period.